Every function in JavaScript has a property called prototype. Every object in JavaScript has a hidden internal property, which is represented by prototype with double square brackets. Since this property is hidden, you can access it through proto property. There's a relation between them. If you create an object using constructor function, the object which gets created has this prototype. This prototype holds the reference to constructor function's prototype. In short, object's prototype holds the reference to constructor function's prototype. Inheritance, it's a concept of accessing one class from another class. If you take this example, we have two classes, a father class and a son class. Here, son class is accessing the properties and methods of father class using the keyword extends. But does JavaScript use this classical way of inheritance? No. Classes are just syntactic sugar in JavaScript. Under the hood, it's using constructor function. And for inheritance, it's using prototypes. That's why it's called prototypal inheritance. Now let's change this class-based code to functional-based one, like this. Let me describe this code. First, I have declared a function called father. Since it's a constructor function, we need to start with uppercase letter. And it has a property called car. And then inside the son function, it has a property bike. Here I have invoked the parent function, father. This is similar to the super here in the class-based one. In this line, I have added a method called getCar. Actually, this method is supposed to be inside here, right? Like this dot getCar. But instead of putting inside this father function, I have added this getCar to father's prototype. This is because if you are creating an object from this function, this method will be created along with the object creation. So if you're creating hundreds of objects with this function, then there'll be hundreds of methods will be created. To avoid this redundancy, we are putting this getCar inside the prototype of father. Same applies here. Here we are adding a method called getBy to son function using the prototype. In the class-based inheritance, we are using extends. So using this, son gets all the properties and methods of father, right? So in the prototype-based inheritance, we are using object constructor, which has a method set prototype of. Using this, son will inherit all the properties and methods of father. So here we are setting the son.prototype with father.prototype. Now let's create an object from son function. Since it's a constructor function, we need to use new keyword. Let's console log this object. If you explore this, you can find the properties bike and car. Okay, fine. And here you can find the prototype. So this is prototype of son. If you explore this, you can find get bike. We are adding get bike to son's prototype. That's how it gets here. So you can check the constructor. Constructor gives the name of the function. It's coming from son function. It has another prototype. This comes from this code. Here we are assigning son.prototype with father.prototype, right? So son gets father's prototype. If you check this, you get the method getCar. GetCar is a method inside father prototype. And you can check here, the constructor, it gives the father function, right? Here you have another prototype. If you check the constructor, it is object with caps O. This is the default prototype, which gets created whenever you are creating an object. So every object, you can see this prototype. Now let's execute all these methods. First, let's start with get bike. Okay, we got the output, and then get cart, and then the method which doesn't exist. We got an error. Okay. Whenever you call a method, first it checks in its own object. If it finds something, it will be returning that, or else it will be moving to the prototype. Same thing happens inside here. First, it will be checking whether it has this method here. If it finds something, it will be returning it, or else moving to the prototype. So going through this prototype chain to find a value is called prototype chain.